Perfected the salsa. Did we make a cinta after sa? That's the question provided. All newly appointed officers, their parents, and all other gentlemen. First of all, I would like to congratulate all the attendees, their parents. Where these boys and girls have got selection in service services and at various levels. Dear officers, now you are the leader of this nation. One myth is there throughout our country that only politicians are our leaders. Doctors, teachers, advocates, judges, officers, they are also leaders. If we escape from this responsibility that only politicians are leaders, they will be free not to lead. You have to own this responsibility of leadership of the nation, of your society. A lot of change will be faced by you when you enter your training institute, your job. Now many things will be imposed upon you, especially if you are NIS or IPS, ECS, PPS, and all other services also. Because till now you are free to do everything. But to mold your personality into a set pattern, it's very important to teach you. You are very brilliant, no doubt. You are outstanding, no doubt. But the employer needs his or her own organizational requirements. Governments have their own goals, whether they are in the state or duties or the central government. You will have to work for their interests, their goals, not the goals of any political party. To be a good administrator, so many researches have taken place for the world. Three basic personal skills are needed. Technical skill, human skill, and conceptual skill. A lot of interrelation is there between the three. But the lower level may be satisfied with the development of technical skill. At higher level, you will have to learn human skills. Human skill is based upon your behavior, your team spirit, and your relations with your colleagues. At the top, you need conceptual skill. You will formulate policies with the help of all others. Single change ordered by you can damage your organization and your leadership, your good decision can an extraordinary event to your organization. Doubtless, you will have to take the risk. Leaders who take risk are real pioneers, they are game changers, they are risk doers. Your role is very challenging, it's not very comfortable. Every day, you will face some new challenge, unlike all other chapters of your life which you have faced. You will have to find your own ways. With keeping patience, a lot of patience is required. When we talk of administration, I would like to remind the inscriptions of Ashoka the Great. He preached two words, Vatsayam and Atmaparishyam, patience in speech and self-examination. Two words are very motivational, not only for your training, but for your entire job. If you think twice before you act or you decide about your organization, about your personality, about the welfare of the people and the goals of democracy, certainly your decision will be a mature and better decision. And that will be appreciated. Risk is there, but if you are democratic enough and you think twice before you do or you decide, there will be no stress. One has to decide and risk is there. One of my personal examples was there. I told my IG that what you like, if I took decision, I was suspended, and had I not taken decision, what would have been there? He convinced me and he told me, okay, this is professional hazard. Maybe you are right or you are wrong. You may be suspended, you may be ousted from your job, you may be fired. But even then, if the intention is good, the day will come and you win. Ashoka the Great is great only because of his administration. He thought about all pros and cons. He gave space to the dissent, to the people who opposed him also. He arranged, he provided facilities to his opponents also, which is required in democracy, unlike monarchy. If a monarch can do so, why the civil servants and the democrats cannot? For good governance, to become a member of better judiciary, you need to learn about the dissent, to listen to the dissent. Once, Ajatshatru, the king of Magadha, sent his minister, Mastakar, to Lord Buddha to ask about the strength of the Yuvajis. He wanted to defeat the Vajji kingdom, the Chalese. He told that good governance is there because they assembled to decide anything regarding any challenge. They are strong. As long as they are sincere to seek the advice of the experienced person, as long as they respect their women, as long as they respect their senior citizens, you cannot defeat them. Their governance is good. Even today, parties will come, political parties will appear and disappear, but the permanent bureaucracy, the institution of civil services will remain, and the entire responsibility of the maintenance of law and order and the bureaucratic mechanism remain in your hands. Your character, your sincerity, your interest will decide. The Constitution of India also guides you a lot. When you go through the Article 38, 1 and 2, you will have to inform social justice, economic justice, political justice to all institutions. You will have close interaction with all individuals, with all institutions, government and non-government. And your decision will benefit them for the welfare of the country. One thing, because of the world system of this country and the culture of centralization, we suffer a lot. And there is a disease of decentralization. You have to go for decentralization. Democracy needs decentralization. If you do not empower your subordinates, certainly they will not be usable for you. And your centralization of powers will be a burden upon your children. If you want to empower your nation, your organization, your community, you need to empower your juniors, your seniors, and the people around you. It is based upon your faculties, your management skill, and your will to empower others. You should evolve a feedback mechanism. Some people are there, they are in a lot of haste. They decide and they tell in a few minutes meeting without listening to the views of others because they are juniors. And you are from it. I assume it. And by birth, you will get time to promotion. And all other juniors are not your competitors. Who is the loser? Who is winner? You lose the feedback. Whatever mission you take, whatever goals you take, you decide. They will be easier to get if you welcome feedback mechanism. Any kind of form of high-handedness, unauthorized use of your authority, is not good for the health of democracy. You come in conflict with politicians, media, judiciary, your fellow officers, every day. It's your foresight, it's your wisdom. You are not doing your job to fight with everyone. You are not a minister of three or six. You have to work with the team given to you. The responsibilities of politicians are also there. They are also accountable to the people. Judiciary also, media also. But the power lies in your signature. Your wisdom matters a lot for the future of the country. Do not fight with any politician. Do not lose patience. I know that so many people are there because of their caste, community, or their background, that they will stop you, that you help that party or you are against that party, political party. That is not in your hand. But the paper you sign, the words you leave, they should not reflect any kind of favor or support. Your support should be for the better thing, for the welfare of the people. Do not think of any criticism on the basis of any stumbling. You are accountable for your soul. When there is any conflict, and rules, regulations, you will have to follow the Constitution of India. This is American president. If you follow the presidents of other countries also, they guide you. The Constitution is this law, right? And prefer to follow them. The responsibility of reconstruction of the society, the responsibility of public welfare is upon you if you feel like that. And if you work only to get some pension or some payment, it's okay. But your image suffers. If you want to work like a hero, even your absence will be noticed. They will think that had he been here, the things would have been different. You will have to take initiative. Don't be an instrument of rat-taping. Some people are there who are so afraid of signature that they love pendency. But the people who love pendency, who are afraid of signature, who do not decide, they are not respected among public, among the organization, and even the people whom you support or any political party or any political settlement, you love or you have any affection, they also like the people who take decisions. I share one experience also. I was transferred because of my bold action regarding